in Birmingham, and thought it'd be a good idea if Chris could give me a little bit of a lesson in swing analysis.
Yeah, we're gonna take a look at swing, aren't we?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right. So let's get started.
So what we got? We got 7-iron.
Yes.
Okay. So if you hit me, I don't know, like six shots or so, mm-hmm. and then what we'll do is have a look at the swings, have a look at the data, and we'll see if we can make any improvements. So what's your iron game like?
You know you're kind of 7, 6, 8 irons.
Yeah,
I think confident with those, or
I think the contact is pretty good normally, but the direction is like not. Sometimes I'll pull it a bit.
Yeah, that's what we're doing.
Yeah.
All right, how are they? Normal. Good?
Yeah, no? I think so. The spray is a bit bigger than
I do. Yeah, we always want it a bit smaller, don't we?
Okay. So you'll see on the screen there, we can look at the swings in this box over here. We can look at kind of what the ball did over here. And then if we expand it, we get all the kind of things like clubhead speed, all those kind of things that kind of give us the information about the ball. So, hey, look, I mean, the first thing is, it's a good goal swing. A really good goal swing.
Thank you.
Really good goal swing. There's lots of really, really good things going on. If we take this swing, for example, and you can see the ball went just a fraction right, but I mean, it was a good shot. When we like take a look at... Sorry, let's get a different one. This one here. When we take a look at the numbers at the bottom, this kind of tells us... These first three numbers tell us how the club basically came into the golf ball. Mm-hmm. So controlling how the club hits the ball is kind of... Everyone's trying to do the same thing. Doesn't matter whether you're a beginner or a high handicap or a mid-handicap or a pro, you're trying to do the same thing. You're trying to get some control over that. So the first thing would be these two numbers here are both really low numbers. Perfect.
Okay.
The first number basically tells us where is the club travelling. Okay. Is it travelling pretty much where you want the ball to go, or is it travelling way off to the right, and we see lots of people where it travels kind of way off either side? Yours is actually travelling within 1 degree of the target.
So it's closest to zero is good?
Yeah, I mean, I would say most golfers are trying to move towards zero.
Okay.
You never have to get there, but if we can be around about... I would normally say I like to be between... Two this way, two that way. So you've kind of got this like 4 degree window. That's going to give you pretty straight shots. So at 1 degree, that's really good. This tells us where the club face is pointing. Okay, and then this one is by far the thing that most golfers get wrong. That's the attack angle. So is that club going down, level, or up? Now, when you've got an iron in your hands and the ball is on the ground, we have to have that as a minus number. Okay, yours is -5. That's perfect. So it's, you know, when we were talking before and you were saying you apply for a really low handicap, I'm expecting to see some decent numbers here, and we get that. If we start to go through high handicappers, 15s, 20s, 25, you start to see those numbers really starting to change. We get -9s and -10s and we get the ball doing all sorts of things. So as best as we can, we're trying to bring these numbers fairly close and have the attack angle down, which is really good. The thing that's interesting with your numbers is that the previous swing, we saw a big number here. Okay, so I'm looking at the way you hit the golf ball and you're hitting some really good shots, and I'm looking at your swing, looking at your shot going perfect, and then the next one is a bit different. So for
that's
you
consistent,
exactly,
right?
So you know, you said maybe you don't play as much as you have in the past and you're trying to maybe play a bit more. That's where that would come in, a little bit more practice, a little bit more play. So let's have a little look at the swing and we'll see kind of what's going on. So I'm going to bring you on the right hand side, other one. So this is the same swing, but obviously just looking at it through two different camera angles. And I'm going to change the numbers. So I'm just going to give ourselves some little reference points that we can work on. On that left, posture, like I'm going to steal that for my lessons. I'm going to use that as an example going forward. I want everyone to stand for the golf ball like that. That's just perfect. Really, really good. Right, this one's good as well on the right-hand side.
So what do you normally look for in a proper posture?
So I like to see this line here that I've drawn. I like to see that behind the heels,
right,
but not too much. I like to see the backs of the shoulders over the grip of the club and on the toe line.
Oh.
And then from that, the arms can then hang straight out. Mm-hmm. Again, it's not what we will see. And then really nice structure in the back, and then perfect end position. Really good. And then obviously alignment is good as well. Really good. Over on this one, pretty good again. You know, I'd like to see your head a little bit more forward. I think drawing a straight line down from your head, it probably hits a little bit closer to your back heel than your front heel, but I think that's mainly because your hips are a little bit back as well. So I would say if that's a straight line down and that's a straight line down, yeah, we're probably a little bit out of sync with the hips, so you're probably a little bit behind the golf ball center, but nothing major. And then as we take these swings through, left hand side, perfect. Club moves directly up that line. Hands are there. I like to see this rotation through here. That's all really, really good. And then as you start to go through to here, now is that something you're used to seeing? You said you kind of bring it a little.
Yeah, I don't think so. Normally, I try to, at that position, the butt of my club is pointing at the ball.
Yeah.
So I think it's a bit round body at this moment.
So I would like to see. I think that club there is in a really good place relative to your shoulders.
Okay.
I'd like to see your shoulders
down more. Okay.
Tipped over a bit more. Yeah.
Yeah, like lower the plane.
Correct.
A bit.
I'd like to see your left shoulder moving a little bit more down. I think that would be really good because what's happening at the moment is your arms getting a little bit below your shoulders.
Yeah.
So your arms get a little bit kind of round here.
Round,
and then you have to then.
Yeah,
kind of lift them a little bit to the top.
Yeah.
So you'll see that left arm now will start to then lift a little bit, and that gets the club a little bit across the line.
Not
loads, but a little bit.
Yeah.
And then, so across the line is, we see the club head more on this side of your hands. I'd like to see the club head a little bit more behind your hands. And then from there, really good. That's perfect. So, I mean, there's always an argument of saying, you know, if someone isn't great on the way back, does it matter if they get it on the way down?
Right.
I like, seriously, really good there. Really good. So you've made really, really nice transition. You've got the club into a really nice position relative to this angle here.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of really, really good things going on there. And as we continue it through to the golf ball, it drops a little bit under, but not major.
Right.
And as you go through, really nice. And on the right hand side, I'd like to see a little bit better structure here.
Right.
I think you said to me that you get a little bit flippy. And there's a couple that you've hit left which would be irresponsive for that. And your hips tend to move forward a little bit.
Okay.
But really, what I'd be looking to do would be to say, well, actually, I really like where you are here.
Uh-huh.
All I'd be really looking to do is organise the backswing a little bit better.
Okay.
So it's not quite as kind of flat in this way, and there's a little bit too much going on. But you know, you're hitting some really, really nice solid shots. It's just for me a case of trying to get it to be a bit more consistent rather than a little bit inconsistent. Okay. Should we show you what I would do?
Yeah.
Okay. So if you want to get yourself set up, bring a ball in. Okay. If you want to get yourself set up to that ball, and just give me a yell when you're pretty comfortable. That there. Okay. So if you try and stay in your posture, but have a look at the screen you see here. So that's now a live feed of you setting up. Okay. So what we sort of see would be that club moves to here, okay, which we are pretty happy that it is. As you turn your shoulders, if this left shoulder goes a little too high, the club's always going to be a little flat. Now obviously we've made it far worse than it is in reality.
Okay.
But if we are in this position here, we don't need to do this with the club.
Mm-hmm.
What we actually need to do is, so you see what happens on the screen when we tip your shoulders.
Yeah.
You get yourself on in the way of the camera there, but you get the idea.
Okay.
So more into this area there.
Yeah.
Okay. So if you want to get back to your setup, stay in that setup posture, but take the club and just pop it across your shoulders. And all I want to try and do
if I stand up guys, you can see that screen, is just start to feel like you make a little bouncing move and get the grip of the club to feel like it moves a little bit more down towards the goal ball. And what we're looking for here is, can we create a little bit more, have an angle through the shoulders? So at the moment, that club would be a little bit too much.
Yeah.
Now, I'm sure you know from golf lessons in the past, you've probably got a feel that it's like this to get it kind of anywhere. Mm-hmm. So then, what I've been then getting you to do, give yourself some feedback. Relax your hands, slide this club all the way through here, so let your hands go down the club. Oh, keep going, keep going, keep going. So now, what we're looking for is, can you make a little batching where you feel like the left shoulder goes a little bit more down, and it's that that allows the club to get pointing on here. So again, if you look in the screen, we can now see that the club is in a much more neutral position, and we've got the grip down there because the shoulder is rounded. So from here, as you turn up to the top, we can get into a much more neutral position.
Wow. Yeah, it's very effortless when you do that.
But notice how your left arm is now hiding this shoulder. Now, we saw it, that shoulder was a bit more visible, and then it kind of went a little bit across this way, and then you had to reroute it. And you were doing a really good job of it because you're a talented goal for that, but we can probably make it
easier.
Yeah, easier.
Okay.
So, take away. Good. Left shoulder down. Beautiful. So that. Good.
And what is the point of having a good backswing?
So, for me, it's all about trying to. I'll give you my example.
Okay.
People laugh at this example, but I'll give you my example. Okay. Imagine this is a hammer, a post, and I've got a hammer and a post. Okay. So I'm going to go this way and this way.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is the best backswing to use.
Yeah.
Okay. So if I use this backswing, I can hammer that post. Okay. Now if I close my eyes, imagine if my backswing was over here.
Yeah.
I can still knock it in, but I've got to get it over here and
down.
And as soon as I close my eyes, I'm So what we're really saying is, we want your downswing to start from a place which is simple. So you can actually, I'm not grasping to close your eyes, but you can theoretically just knock it and think about it. Whereas at the moment, if we think of your goal swing like a hammer, your backswing is going over here, and you're trying to kind of
find it.
And so if you went and played five times a week for the next 6 months, you'd be like, because you've figured out a way to time.
Right.
But we want a goal swing where you can not play for 2 weeks, tee it up and still play.
And
you can still have days. You can play 5 times a week to
have bad timing that day, like whether you woke up on the wrong side of the bed.
And sometimes, if you're swinging the line, you're just struggling to find it. So take this position. And this time we're doing the same thing.
Don't need to do this.
But we're going to do it with the club before. Maybe you actually need to do it here. You see, I'm just going to go down to the wall. And then we go this way. If you just hold that there, okay. I know it's not comfortable, just hold for a second. And you can relax. Okay, it's fine.
That's perfect.
So, what we are wanting is. I move out the way.
Yeah, that's a big difference. And at the top, are they same spots?
So this one on the right is now when you'll start to try and kick the club across a little bit.
Yeah.
But yeah. So if I put the same line on. So your hands get quite low behind you,
yeah.
And then you have to then lift up a little bit, and then the club gets a little bit across. So, you know, at the top, they're not as different.
Yeah.
I prefer this a little bit, but it's the way it gets there, which is probably
the
a little bit better. Correct.
As well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then from here, then really, I'll be saying to you, just make your normal bounce.
Right.
Okay. So the way I would get you to then hit balls would be freezes.
Okay.
Face up.
Yeah.
Up. Freeze.
Okay.
Okay. So you need to take a mental image of that. On the left. Okay. So you're going to set yourself up now. Okay.
Like a 2 second freeze?
Yep.
but you're going to check in that screen whether you're happy with the top.
Yeah, okay.
So you're going to go back to me. Happy?
Happy.
Good. Hit it. There you go, good. So that's your next stage. It's just kind of making a move, checking if you're happy with it, and you'll hit some left and some right and some not great shots, but that's the next phase, to try and get you to feel that will be like, you know,
with the, what it feels like.
Yeah, with a bit of board in the way. And, now, lots of people, when they come to see me, they actually need something to change because it's the ball's going offline. But you're hitting really good shots. It's more a case of, I always call it, you've got really good stuff. My job is to pull away the things that are distracting from that, and we're left with some really good things. And that'll be how I do it. It's going to be a case of changing your backswing by getting the lead shot a little bit more down, club shaft be in a better position, then getting more you from the top.
Yeah.
You can just play golf for your iceberg.
Let it go, I like that.
Yeah.
That would be the goal. So it's not to feel like you're lifting your arms, it's just that
you're,
where your shoulder
is. There's a little bit of arm lift. Yeah, so as you go to here, so as your left shoulder goes down, your arm now needs to feel like they go up a little bit. There you go, that's your perfect position. Your arms definitely go a little bit too much around. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, really good. That was my shot.
Thanks.
Really good. Really good.
All right.
Worked on that?
Yeah, I will definitely work on that.
Perfect. You have better weather in LA to work on it.
Yeah. It's nice. The ball doesn't go as far here, I guess.
Not today.
No heat.
No.
Well, thank you so much, Chris, for all your time.
Pleasure.
And for my lesson. And don't forget to check out his YouTube channel. I'm going to link it right over here. Subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell so you don't miss a video. We'll see you next time. Bye.
We're going to be late.